Hello and welcome to a new video featuring the Matrixers with Jonathan,
Jonathan
and the Shiva. Yes, you asked us, how do we know that everything we tell you in the videos? How did we come to our experiences? And that's what this video is going to be about today. Yes, we are often asked in emails or in comments. Yes, how do you know all this? How do you want to be so sure that it's all true and stuff like that? Something that is often asked about how do you want to know if that's true and how do you all know that? We thought, let's make the video now and explain how we deal with knowledge, how we get knowledge and what kind. Of knowledge we accept and what kind of knowledge we tend to leave as theory in the room.
Erstmal als Theorie im Raum stehen lassen.
Exactly. Genau. So knowing what we accept
wissen,
is easy.
Akzeptieren ist einfach.
Alles all just what I've seen myself. All right.
Na gut.
Yes, that is an important point you raise.
Punkt, den du ansprichst. Genau.
Exactly. That we tend very strongly to only believe what we have experienced ourselves, not what someone tells us, what they have seen or maybe even just read or heard. We just categorically don't believe that at first. We take the information, see if we might see the same thing, but as long as we haven't seen it, we don't believe it either. Because as you know, there is so much information in this world and above all there are errors and incorrect information. That we took ourselves out of there right now. And there's so much propaganda in politics, and I think there's even more propaganda in the spiritual sector. Yes, so what propaganda there is. A lot of people just talk in a way that suits them or they talk in such a way to reach a large number of viewers. Or they talk about spirituality in such a way that everything is peace, joy, pancakes. So it's very different how it all looks like. And in my book, Spiritual Dissociation, I once described dissociation versus relativism. Because the philosophy of relativism says that everyone is right with what they say. And for some it is Ashtar, the fleet commander, and for whom else is it God, and for whom else again?
Gott und für wen anders wieder
the Arcturians.
Arcturians? Genau.
Exactly. And well, naja, before we get into the topic, we will now tell you how we come to our knowledge. So the first thing, of course, is dissociation. We both started doing this many years ago, training it. It came to us, and that's actually where we have the best successes. The spiritual dissociation is actually very similar to the dissociation as one knows it, only that one is not a victim of this dissociation or dissociative moments, but uses it intentionally and in a controlled manner and thereby comes to knowledge and for example, to out-of-body experiences, lucid dreams, clairvoyant moments that can arise.
Hellseherische Augenblicke, die
findings,
Erkenntnisse.
Exactly. And the exciting thing about it is that everyone sees the same thing.
Jeder das Gleiche sieht.
Yes.
Yeah.
It doesn't matter who practices dissociation. Everyone perceives the same thing without having agreed beforehand, without even knowing each other. That's exciting. That's the point. In psychology, what you perceive during dissociation is a hallucination. A hallucination. But do they all hallucinate the same way? Yes, that's very funny, because everyone who uses dissociation comes to the same results and to the same insights and to the same impressions of perception. And that's a strange hallucination for me. Yes. A hallucination is defined as perceiving something that no one else is perceiving, and that over thousands of kilometers away, for example. Correct. Yes, and dissociation is therefore, of course, the master technique for us. Yes. Because everything is actually possible with it if you know how it works, how to use it, how to achieve it. and dissociation is definitely our primary source of knowledge.
Unsere primäre Wissensquelle.
What we perceive in dissociation as reality for us is true reality for us. The real reality is that. Yes, my second favorite hobby horse is hypnagogic states. I'm particularly fond of them. I train them a lot and for a long time. I neglected her for a year or two, but it's my turn again. Anyway, with the hypnagogic states, you can go to other places to explore. You go there with your consciousness and look at everything calmly. You can also program where you want to go. If you say, I want to go to China somewhere, because at least for me, I came to China and was able to look around there. Or I asked questions. Something like, yes, what can you say here now? A lot of questions anyway, and I always get an answer from outside. Well, it doesn't come from them, but really, as if someone were here next to me, standing there and giving me the answer. You also get support in hypnagogic states. For example, when you practice lucid dreaming like with me, at some point someone asks me, and are you already dreaming? Oh, well, that's really good, because you ask yourself all day. During the reality checks, I dream and then go hypnagogic, and then someone asks you, so are you dreaming already? Is that really cool? In hypnagogic states, you can really learn a lot and ask a lot of questions. I just do it by picking a question and repeating it over and over again until I get into that state. And as soon as I'm in this area, the answers come from above. And you can really learn a lot with it, if you want to. And yes, I really like using it. Yes, Shiva always has many hypnagogic states and is often in that state and always gets the most interesting information. So I really trained a lot. Now that's not the training. Yes, then we also use out-of-body experience. Out-of-body experience means detaching yourself from your body and then going to other levels of reality or other dimensions of reality, and of course you can get in touch with others who give the impression that they are already much more spiritually developed than any person on Earth.
Die den Eindruck machen, als wären die schon spirituell viel weiterentwickelt als irgendein Mensch auf der Erde.
And of course, you can also get information there, and of course, you have to be a bit careful.
Und da muss man natürlich auch ein bisschen aufpassen.
I remind some of all these channeling contacts that are out there. It is also claimed that they are in contact with higher beings and they say everything exactly as it is and such. I personally don't think so much of it. You not like that either? Yes, we agree on it. Was and still is a difference for me whether I'm sitting there and channeling someone who I don't know 100%, who is actually there at the other end of the line, or whether I'm flying around with my astral body and then suddenly forward standing in
zugegen ist, oder ob ich
front of the person or in front of the personality and being able to feel it there. How's the personality there? What identifier? How sophisticated might it be? And there you can estimate more. The information she gives, yes, so out of body experience. And of course you can also experience many things without a body experience. And see for yourself how it behaves when you somehow try to leave the Earth with your astral body and then you slam an electric fence against it, you know. You. Yes, there is an electric fence and you can't get through it astrally. You can only get through it with tricks. Yes, exactly. So that, you'll be thrown back. That's funny. Yes. Doesn't hurt, yes, not really. So for us, that's the primary source of information. Dissociations, hypnagogic states, and of course out-of-body experience. But also the dreams. The dreams too. This is where the most exciting information is often found. Correct dreams, because memories can be hidden in dreams, for example. Memories from other lives or memories from before the Matrix, for example. Or just information about the Matrix. Also often had. So very interesting. Yes, and these are our primary sources of information. Because what we read in some news or books or see other video channels and what is said and claimed there.
Andere Videokanäle so sehen und was da so gesagt und behauptet wird.
Some hit the nail on the head, while others, we would say, are still a long way from the right topic. And everything that you can read somewhere and the like is also a question of faith for us. You can believe it or not, but it is important for us to see it for ourselves, so that it is no longer just belief, but knowledge. And that, to me, is the difference between knowing and believing. I believe that I do things that I have not yet experienced myself, but which I assume are true. But knowledge is for me. Inner knowing is for me. I have experienced it and I know it is so. That's our answer to what sources of information we all have, which sources of information we listen to, and which ones we don't listen to at first. Yes. So we have also largely switched to not watching videos or reading books at all. Actually, not at all. So we are often sent videos or links. We don't look very often, very rarely that we look at one, but because we want to and should rely more on our inner knowledge. Exactly as you have seen, except our videos. Yes, of course we watch videos from time to time or something. There are always a few interesting channels where we say yes, what he says sounds very exciting, doesn't it? Yes, very interesting. But with many videos you notice after the first 2 minutes that you think you already know it or you already know the view. Or is it just a new dress that someone else missed, that knowledge, therefore, or many just talk about knowledge that they have not experienced themselves. Actually, these are the videos that I personally don't particularly enjoy watching. People who have read something somewhere and reproduce it in a video and present it as knowledge. And now everyone has to believe that. So yeah, that's actually what I don't like to watch. Well, there are also people who have received knowledge, for example through books, and build a new teaching from it as an example, but have not had any experience themselves. That is the point. I've also met people who have workshops on out-of-body experience and have never experienced an out-of-body experience. Never. But he offered workshops, so something like that, for example, to take an example. And that's why everyone who writes to us and contacts us always says, yes, how do you know all this? How do you know that's true and all? We cannot 100% prove what we perceive. We can only show circumstantial evidence. You can only prove it to yourself. And then if we say learn the dissociations, for example, learn them and you'll see what's going on behind the scenes of the matrix. And you see that in the dissociation. And no matter who had the courage and said, yes, I'm learning this now. I want to see if it's really like Shiva and Jonathan say and sit down and dissociate, and then in that moment suddenly the same perceptions arise. Yes, that was our video. Where did Shiva and Jonathan get their knowledge from? Of course it is. It requires a lot of... It's not like we were born with that. So of course we were all born with it. Unfortunately, we forgot everyone again, so we had to practice everything. And that's exactly what we're applying and telling you about what we've experienced ourselves, right? And what we have experienced ourselves is what we have seen. What we have seen with our pineal gland or inner eye through the dissociation or hypnagogic states. And that is our source of knowledge, and that is also the absolute source of knowledge for us. We do not provide any newspaper, no books, no videos about this source of knowledge. They are subordinate to it. And that makes the difference, I think, to many others who also deal with spirituality. Because many people are always trying to somehow gather a lot of knowledge from reading and watching 1,000 books, attending 1,000 workshops, that sort of thing. And that's gathering knowledge from the outside. We collect our knowledge from within, and that is important to us. It takes longer, but that's how it is. Yes. Of course, we get a lot of stuff too. So it's clear from the people who write to us who say, yes, I've seen that, seen this, what do you think of it or something, or what do you say about this video and everything. So we're not entirely out of the loop. No, not quite out of the world. Not quite out of the world. Ever heard of that? Yes. Yeah, the video was intended for those who were interested. Where did Shiva and Jonathan get their knowledge from? And we often just have the same experiences. So they are not agreed now. Everyone makes their own experiences or insights, what they see, and then we exchange ideas. So even we had the same experiences, independently of each other, even before we knew each other. So you can too. And if you feel like it, write your experience about dissociation in the comments, how you collect your knowledge or what your technique is for you. Yes, that would be cool. Until next time. See you soon. My dear God, look.